Alright, welcome back. Last time we fought some Wilhelms and some flies, and we're gonna come up here, because I think this is what I was instructed to do. Grevik dropped us a hot tip saying, like, you need to go talk to some people. Oh, shit. I guess this is the people?
Thou art Ash. Thou hast a pact made with Uncle Gale, so I wish to tell thee all. Behold its size. This is my canvas. It's to be a cold, dark, and very gentle place. But first, I must see flame. I wish to paint a picture of a cold, dark, and very gentle place. One day, it will make someone a goodly home. That's why I must see flame.
Goodly? Bigly?
I wish to paint a picture of a cold one. That's why I'm...
Here, let me step on your hair real quick. Okay. She got her little painter's beret or whatever on, and clearly she's been... I don't know, she's really focused on her painting, right? Because she has all this hair, which I'm sure is a complete pain in the ass to wash when she chooses to. Because think about how long that would take. You know, how long would it actually take to wash that? Would you bother washing it? At some point, she bothers to put a hair tie in it. So maybe it's worth it. Actually, she has like some parachute strings or something. Looks like it only comes down part way and then... I don't know. This is probably a bad idea to record right now because I... only slept a couple hours last night. I slept about 3. I don't know what it was. I woke up at 3:30 this morning and I could not go back to sleep. And so I just kind of got up and I started doing stuff. I started watching some of my favorite streams. And I was watching, you know, I was playing Warframe for a little bit. And I don't think she has anything new for us. No, she doesn't. And when I was doing all that stuff, I'm kind of... Oh, shit.
Flame flickering once again. Not enough blood yet, Shade. My flail. Bring me my flail. Ah, Frida. What stops thine ears? Please, my flail.
Okay. I don't know where that flail is. I'm pretty sure when I give it to you, you're gonna fucking smash me with it. Let's walk in here. Probably start the presumptive boss battle. There are bloodstains in here. People rolling. Can I talk to you? I'd like to talk to you. You know, I like to kiss before I fuck. So... Oh, what the fuck? Is he like a... What is he? He's holding a... A bowl. Oh, his head's in there. Oh shit! I wanted to look at the message! Is that a Lord Vessel? Don't look at us.
Oh, bring Frida to me, please. Canst thou not see the flame flickering once again? Soon will it surge. I can see it, feel it.
Is only the flame quivering at misguided ash. Please avert thine eyes. will snuff out these ashes for good.
Here we go. Gonna go invisible over there, Priscilla. It's just some chip damage. Oh, there she goes. Ooh, she's got the moves. I don't know where she is. I guess maybe we can roll into her and do some damage. Nah. I'm assuming there she is. She got some tracking. There she goes. Try and make her walk through the shit. She has no poise, which is pretty nice. She got a new stance. Oh shit. Oh, these always get me. There's probably a tell to see where she's coming from. Oh. Is that gonna kill me? No, but that does suck to get hit by. That's actually a really nasty attack. Just trying new stuff, trying to hit her. God, we could have did so much damage right there if I could have actually got like the hit. Oh really? Ooh, that's actually kind of scary. It's just the attack you don't want to get hit by. Oh. See, sometimes she like kind of gives you a second and comes out and you get to react, but that time she was. Got me. Back rolls. You gotta roll into her. Just gonna fucking spam roll. It sucks because she'll. I feel like she picks a spot that your camera's not facing. And that had a lot of tracking right there. I disagree with getting hit by that. Oh my god. Looks like I'm gonna have to actually dodge one of these again to actually kill her. I'm probably not going to. Fuck, I wanna kill her, dude. That is so garbage. There she is. Right in the head. Oh, is this like the first phase? I was gonna say, that was a little too simple. I really wish it wasn't a two-phase boss, though. I'm kind of over that. I'm over two-phase bosses. Especially in this game, there's a lot of... You kill one thing and then something happens. Thank you. guy looks really mad. This was a really dramatic showing. Is she getting up? Oh my goodness. You have to fight them both. Oh my god, this concept is new and original. I don't know what he's doing behind me. I have like a joint life bar. Oh, fuck that. I just want to hit him and see what happens. Remember that time I was like, I want to hit him and see what happens? And then I died. Yeah. Alright, so I'm slightly crabby because I'm fucking exhausted. And so that's why I feel like recording this right now is a bad idea, especially with a boss. So I don't know how I'm going to beat a boss with no sleep and a crabby attitude, but you know what? We're going to try. My criticisms, first of all, are I'm really 100% over the two-phase boss mechanic where, you know, you fight one and then it's two, or you fight two and then it's one super one. Like, I'm done with that. I'm so fucking past that. And that's what's happening right here. You know, it's just, you kill the little one, and then the little one comes back to life, and they have to fight her and the big one. Thankfully, they have one total life bar. I think that's actually cool, because they don't usually do that. And I don't know, the reason I don't like it is just because it's really predictable in terms of a plot device. I don't know if plot device is the right term. But yeah, it would be nice if I walk in here and I fight the two of them together. That would be cool. But no, I'm going to have to kill Freed again and then deal with the duo. And the reason I don't like the duo is because they keep doing the same thing. They have like the giant dude who's always like super nimble and super fucking fast. That's exactly what's about to happen. It's like he runs across the room and slams his giant fucking dinner bowl all over the place and spills his porridge. I won't get a chance to do this again. Not that it really helps. We'll get better at fighting her at least. Oh, you didn't do your charge up, huh? I said we were gonna get better at fighting her. I'm just really impatient right now. Like, I want to disrespect the fuck out of her. Which is a big problem I have when I fight bosses. Because I feel like I understand it. And I don't want to play the regular game anymore. What I mean by that is I'm so... Okay. Like, I understand how she works, but I don't... Because I feel that I understand her now, I feel like I don't have to do the normal boss fight, is what I'm trying to say. I don't know if that makes sense. That's my mentality behind it. Got lucky with that stagger. Damn, she's got some reach. Really thought I was gonna get a backstab, that's why I went for it. We're doing a lot of damage to her. Oh, lol. lock-on completely failed. I was trying to lock onto her first. I thought I was going to turn around and pick her up, and it didn't. Oh yeah, hit Dad. Hit Papa. I think she went Viz. I don't have my sound high enough, but I know she has audio cues. There, see, that's getting impatient again. Aw, shit. I was gonna try and, like, buff up in time, but it didn't happen. I guess I have a chance there. I'm dead. Oh my god, see, this is so fucking garbage. This is so garbage. This is the worst type of fight to put in this game, and they fucking keep fucking doing it. Oh my god. Because the reason it worked with ONS is because... I'm going to rant a little bit here. The reason it works with ONS, which is Ornstein Smell, the reason it worked there is because the two bosses were designed to work together. Not so much intentionally where they have combo attacks. The reason it works is because Ornstein has projectiles, he's small, he's nimble, he jumps across the stage, and, you know, he fights that way. Smo is big, he runs at you, but that doesn't make him, like, super fast. You could kite Smo, and he just hits really hard, and he's fucking slow. So you have one nimble guy that doesn't hit super hard, who jumps around the whole time, and he's balanced out by a really slow big guy that takes up a lot of space. And if you want to run and kite Smo the entire fight and kill Ornstein first, you can do that. If you want to get up in Smo's face and dodge his shit and wedge Ornstein behind him, which isn't that hard to do, you can do that. And then when you kill one, you have to fight the super version of the other, but by themselves, they're not too bad. And that's what the whole fight is splitting them up. And then when you get them to the second phase, it's still not too hard. I mean, I say that now when I fucking died for 3 hours the first time I did that fight, but the reason it's not too hard now is because once you get used to one of their attack patterns, the super version just gets like one new attack. And they hit you a little harder, so they do punish you, but I mean, it makes sense. The reason it doesn't work here is because this boss so far does not have that feel of being designed to work together. Freed is small and agile, which is fine, but then the big guy is fast and runs across the stage. Like, Freed takes precision and timing, and you have to bait openings. Like, you play her like a normal boss, you have to bait openings and punish them, which is fine, but then while you're doing that, because it takes so much time to do some of that sometimes, the giant motherfucker runs across the room and just starts slamming the floor. That's why it doesn't work, because he slams the fucking floor all the time, so you can't play against Freed the way you're supposed to. So you're like, okay, maybe I'll fight the big guy, but then Freed, since you can't see her, she'll just go invisible and she'll fucking grab you for half your HP when she decides to pop out, because you have to keep track of her. I don't know. Obviously, I need more practice with it, but I think I'm going to... I want to do, like, a really kite-heavy fight and see how it works. I actually like fighting Freed. I didn't block there. Like, I was thinking I was gonna get a backstab, so I didn't do it. I should have attacked. She gave me all the time in the world. Like, I completely... Like, that was bad play. I will always and forever be willing to say I played bad. She like, okay. I thought I heard her, but I didn't see her. Yeah, I'm gonna have to die to Freed. This just feels like a die to Freed attempt. Yeah, because again, I'm impatient and I'm tilted. I'm so tilted because I hate that double fight. I just don't like those fights, and they keep doing it. I don't understand why. Yeah, this whole video is looking to be like, I'm just gonna die to this fight over and over. I mean, I'm gonna do my best, but it's just, yeah, it's just gonna be that. That was actually cool too, how she, like, she went into that stance and then she decided not to do anything with it, which is cool. I like that she kind of evolves. Okay, so I think she jumps, that's what it is. There, okay. I know how it works. You almost want to bait that attack now, huh? Because she jumps over you, and then you can just force her. Okay. Aw. Oh, I don't like that she can get out of backstabs consistently. That's gonna hit me for sure. Cause drinking. Oh man. I have time to drink actually. Oh, did she not jump that time? That was kinda weird. She did like a little flicker. I wonder if her invis bugs out like that. It's gonna hit me. Oh, it didn't. That one should've hit me. Let's see if she actually jumps. Yeah. Can almost walk up and start mashing. Oh, alright, that test failed. Damn it. I didn't want to use a potion there, but I feel like I had to. See, now she's being hella passive. She wants this guy to attack me. Okay, she's on my right. I can only get a couple hits, and I gotta go. I don't know where he's getting all that liquid. Come on, Freed. I guess this is when I'm... Oh. Oh, why does that do so much damage? Well, the room actually got a lot bigger, though, because he burned the bookshelves. So that's helpful. I see her over there, but, like, look at... He just fucking walks! Like, I actually could have got some good damage in there. You know, I just need to roll out. That's what it is. Need a fucking Optimus Prime. Okay, I'm starting to see it. Like, she gets really passive, but she's basically just gonna throw ice waves at me, and then he's gonna run at me. I don't like taking my eyes off him. Like, since she's so passive, I can just fucking walk up to her like this. Now she's doing it. She dashed. What the fuck is that? Oh, she's healing! That's garbage. Like, that's... I knew I should have ran over there, but that's still garbage. They need to not have these healing bosses. Oh, I'm just dead, aren't I? I think she... Okay. I was gonna say, she did something. I didn't see what it was. He's got fire. He's just building up an attack. Fuck. Oh my god. That's such a bad spot. That fucking, the player phantom not helping me right there. Still too slow on that. Fuck, what? Oh my god, I didn't know it did that. I mean, they only showed it to me like 18 times, I should have learned, but... She's at. There she is. I got really lucky, but no! I keep forgetting that attack does that. That's twice. Back roll, back roll, back roll, back roll. Oh my god, I can't even see all this shit together. We gotta end this fight now. He's the easier- oh my god. I think I actually stopped it there. But I'm fucking dead because I'd spent all my stamina sprinting in. That's so garbage! I had this! Oh my god. I guess I think the correct thing right there was to let them do it. I should have just let her heal. Because I had to spend all my stam running in there. And then I fucking died for it, because I didn't have enough stam to, like, spam roll out of there. Alright, okay, so, I get it. I get it, but this is... I was really hoping to close it out, that attempt, too. I'm gonna get rid of my... I'm gonna switch my Estus, I'm gonna get more healing pots. But this is the part of the fight that I hate. This is when I run into my problems, usually, with bosses. Is... it comes down to execution now, because I understand the fight. I think I've learned enough from my mistakes. I understand how to beat Freed. I'm not perfect. Well, I'm obviously not perfect, but... I'm not, like, super confident that I fully... understand the second phase, but I still get it. You know, I understand that he has these periods where he... like, he'll do a bunch of attacks, and then he'll sit there for, like, 20 seconds. And, you know, just kind of dick around. So I understand that. And then I understand that she's more passive in phase 2 and just likes to spam her ice waves, which is fine. So I understand that too. But now the problem is putting it together. Because like I was saying before, once I understand a fight, I start disrespecting it, which is not how you play this game. You have to respect it the whole time. Because when you disrespect it and you're careless, that's when you make mistakes and you get blown up for it. And so if I go in there and think, oh, this ain't shit, and start trying to, like, wail on Freed the whole time, and, you know, use, like, 4 health pots on the first phase, then I'm going to be in bad position for the second one. And it just sucks because since the second part of the phase, or second phase of the fight seems a little longer, I can't go the disrespect route. Because, like, I have to play out the whole thing. I have to run around for a couple seconds at a time and get my hits in and all that, so. But I get it. I still, my criticisms still stand. Alright, I still think this is really stupid and overplayed, but... like I said, I do like fighting Freed. I think she herself is pretty cool. She looks pretty badass. Tried to roll through that. I tried to roll really early and I didn't get it. No, wait, she went the other way. Actually, maybe. Oh, she did. I was right. Okay. So I was trying to piece together what the smoke means when she dashes. Because I know it means she did dash and not jump. Aw. Yeah, see, she goes that way. Okay. Oh, she fucking played me right there. I thought she was gonna, like, do her little stalker walk. I'm dead. Yep. It's one of the few times she's actually done that attack where she holds her swing. Because a lot of her attacks line up pretty well with mine. So when I feel like I need to dodge and I just do, like, the reflexive spam dodge kind of thing, it's usually right through her swing. But that one right there, I mean, you could probably see it. She held it for an extra second. And I think that's an attack specifically to punish what I do, where you start spam rolling when you're in danger. And so I died for it. I think I knew it before she even hit me. I gotta go back and see the tape. I'm pretty sure I called it out the moment I saw she didn't swing. I was like, yep, that's it. And she has to do chip damage, because think about if she couldn't. You know, if you could just full block her the whole time, she'd actually be really easy. So right there, I tried to roll through her and I didn't get it. Like, I rolled into her instead of through her. That's gonna hit me. Wow. Yeah, I tried to roll through her, I didn't get it. I rolled into her body and I ate an attack for it. Normally, this is about when I start cutting out the fights. And I make a little montage, and I try and sit there and think through it and all that. I just don't have the capacity right now, so I'm just gonna throw myself at this for a little bit longer. And we'll see what happens. I'm at 33 minutes. I'm not quite sure how much I'm gonna cut. But aside from bitching about this boss, I'm super tired, and I'm not saying that's why I'm playing bad. I'm saying that's why I'm so crabby. But the other thing about... what is it, not sleeping right now, is I have homework to do still. That's the one. See, that's the one, that's the hold attack that punishes rolls. Logically, I should keep making her try and use her invisible attack. There it is again. Like, it punishes you if you try and go in. Is what it is. She jumped. Oh my god, she keeps hitting me with it. I don't know, she's being a little harder this time, I feel like. Oh, that's so mean. Damn. I do hate that she can... okay, so she hyper-armors at some point. Because I hit her clean twice right there. Oh, I saw that late. Actually, I don't know where she went that time. Maybe she didn't move at all. I guess she went to that side. Damn. Look at that, I did no damage. For like how long that fight went, I thought I got a couple good hits too, and I looked down and she still got a third of her HP. I don't know. I'm not that focused anymore. And this is the... I really hate not closing out boss fights when you're actually really close to doing it. It's one of the worst feelings, because now I have to go back and I have to do the the whole, like, 5-6 minute fight again. And the only difference with the last run compared to, or not the last run, but the one where I almost beat it than any others was maybe like 1200 HP. You know, they were close. I'm almost thinking I should just block her. Like, I gotta deal with this attack. Thought she'd be by the tables or something. Oh, that's bullshit! Yeah, see, I'm just getting impatient. If there's one thing this game does well, it's punishing you for being impatient. Thought she was gonna evade that time, she didn't. So even though she's like disappearing through that last hit. Ah, okay, I like that. If you actually get close enough, you can see her. It's gonna hit me. Oh, it didn't. There we go. I'm too close to buff, I think. Okay, no, it actually, either I was close enough, or it actually spawns me back there. I really do think blocking her is a legitimate strategy. The more I do this. Oh, fuck, I was not expecting that. That might actually kill me here. Yeah, I can't do anything like that. The fire covered so much of the ground that the first hit of the fire opened me up. And normally, the game is pretty good about not letting some kind of persistent chain attack kill you in that situation, like specifically fire breath. If you ever notice, my personal experience, which I know I just talked shit about personal experience in the last video, but I don't remember many times where like fire breath and shit will sit there and grind me down for all my HP, because usually it hits hard enough by itself. And I'm pretty sure with him, with the big guy, I don't even know his name, I'm not looking at the health bar when they spawn, but I'm pretty sure that the big guy, one or two of the times he hit me with the fire attack, I'm pretty sure it doesn't combo itself, if you get what I'm saying. And I think that Freed hit me with a fucking reset, because I got hit by the fire, and then I know she hit me with her scythe, and I think that comboed me, so I got hit by the fire, and then her scythe reset my hit, so the fire could hit me a second time, and then the fire killed me. Pretty sure that's what happened. I'm about to probably fucking start embering, because I feel like I'm close. It's just really about putting it together. You know, which is exactly what I said like 10 minutes ago. Oh! Was not paying attention. She fucking did a 3-chain, which is not common, but she does have it. And so, the reason I was thinking it's probably okay to just block her is because she doesn't do a lot of guard crush. She does do some chip damage, but it's like, the trade-off for getting a hit in, if I block one of her strings, I take, I don't know how much chip damage, but I don't take that much. I take, you know, maybe like 5% of my HP or something. And in return, I usually get 2 or 3 hits in on her, which is actually not too bad of a trade, I feel like, especially if I have Blessed Weapon going, because then I'll get a little bit of that HP back. So that's what I was saying, that I think blocking's a legitimate choice against her. I do wish she wouldn't jump out of that. So So I feel like if you're gonna let me backstab the boss... Really? Because I feel like if you're gonna let me backstab the boss, and I... do good positioning, that I should get the reward for it. The flip side of that is maybe you don't go for backstabs. I got greedy right there, because I tried to... What is it? In response? When I felt that she was doing her little three attack chain, I tried to drop my guard for a half second in between. Because if I was able to do that, then I get a little bit of stamina back, but it didn't happen that way. There's that hyper armor, which is like, it's not common enough that I should be playing around it, is how I feel. I was gonna say, she should give me one more invis attack. It's over here. I don't know where. Yep. Fuck, dude. I don't know the lateral movement on that yet. I'm dead. That's so garbage. She should have been dead. Like, she straight should have died there. And I got so greedy for it. But she got me with a side dash because I don't quite know where the side dash goes. Because I don't know, like, in my head, I don't know if she makes a circle, or if she makes a line, or if she actually goes backwards. I think she goes backwards a little bit from where she starts. It's really hard to tell. At least for me. And it sucked, too, because that's the attack I wanted. I totally called it. You know, I was like, she should give me one more invisible. And she did. But she fucking killed me for it. And then, because I got so greedy with my stamina and attacking her, she guard broke me for a kill. So that was my fault. I'm not saying that a lot of these deaths aren't my fault. They're 100% my fault. And the reason I like going for the backstab too, I know that I shouldn't be going for them, is the backstab's actually a lot of damage, because you get the 588 for the initial hit. She usually hyper armors me when I mash on her in that situation, so I'm trying not to. I should walk to her other side, too. Because look, I get the knockdown, and then I get a couple extra hits. It's the most damage, and it's usually the best positioning. I think she's over here. Yep. Yeah, the reason it's the best positioning, too, is because she's the one that has to get up and deal with, you know, my aggression, which is usually what you want. I want the jump. There we go. Yeah. I normally don't mash on her, but I knew I could kill her there if I did, so I went for it. Alright, now comes the actual hard part. This is not a good spot to be. I wanted to hit her so bad right there. He's moving. I'm dead. I can't dodge all this shit. That's a new one. But then again, I'm not usually that close to him, so I never see his attacks. Damn, her positioning is really good, because she'll do her ice thing and then jump over it. And then it's like, well, if you want to fight me, you have to cross it. What happens if I get right the fuck here? Fuck it. You have to give it to him. How much life is that? Fuck, that's a lot. Then I miss. I mean, how much does he get back from that? Like 20%? My positioning is good right here, though, because Freed's on the other side. So I just have to watch out for that. It's not good, though. I burned too much stamina. Get top off. Damn, she's just going off right now. Not good. Just gonna go to the other side of the room. Hopefully Free doesn't kill me for it. I'm trying to make him do an attack over there. Oh, she's still... Damn. Oh, that could not have been better. I'm not in a good spot, though. Fuck! No, I wanted in there! Damn it, I saw that attack too late. I could have killed him right there. Okay. Blam! I'll take the slab, thank you. No! Am I just dead? God, now she's hell of aggressive, does hell of fucking damage. I'm already low on resources. Thought I saw her go over here. There she is.
Thought of us from thy might, as thy kind always have.
Okay, so I didn't get souls either. So that means the boss isn't dead, but I got the slab. So... Oh, if that is a three-phase fight, I'm actually gonna put this game down. Oh my god. I can't do that! Not now, anyway. Like, I would have to try that for several hours. Alright, so this is post-commentary, and this should be the right attempt. I recorded for about 2.5 hours today of trying to kill her. As I said, my previous quick update that I made, like, for 20 seconds long. And I really... Having fought her this much, she is easily the hardest boss in the series for me. I don't even think it's close. Because, you know, people say when you play your other games that they're hard because it's your first Souls game. Which, Ornstein and Smough and Gwyn and a couple others in Dark Souls 1 really took me a long time, but again, that was because, you know, it was like the first game, and this one, I don't really have any quote-unquote excuse like that. I've played enough Dark Souls, and this was just confirming that I am, like, I never thought I was a really good player or something like that. I thought I wasn't garbage. I thought I was, like, you know, pretty average. And having played this, I don't even feel that way anymore, and I'm not saying that for pity or something like that. I just can't for the life of me put this boss together where I'll have a couple attempts where I'll get through phase 1 easily, and then, like, I'll go through phase 2. And I've only gotten to phase 3, like, 6 times. I'll get to phase 3, and then it just falls apart. I don't know what it is. Like, it's really hard to learn phase 3 because she does so much damage at that point. So where, you know, you make like one or two mistakes at the start of the fight and you're just dead. You know, you can't really, it's hard to learn from there, and then it takes so long. It's not too easy to get back. Phase 1 is kind of a, by the way, I thought the mannequin claws were like the best that I've used so far for this. It doesn't seem too good for phase 3. So I don't know, maybe I'll do some weapon switching, but if you see here, the roll attack with the claws are actually really good. Because if I roll the second hit on her combo, like, I can block the first hit, roll the second, and then when it rolls, it, sorry about that. Yeah, when it rolls, the claws, if you don't remember, have their rolling attack causes another roll. So you basically roll twice. And it has some pretty good tracking, some pretty good reach. And since it rolls, sometimes it rolls through her, like, third attacks on her chains, or, like, you'll go past it. And I can actually, you see it all the time, I feel like, where I can just, I don't even have to think about where I'm dodging with her thing, as long as I hit that attack, and then it rolls back in, and I get, you know, it's like 150. It's still pretty good. Look at the damage on this, though, with the dual-wield mash combo. And what's so good about those is it doesn't even take a lot of stamina, which is why I like it, because he has about 6,000 life, maybe like 6,500 at this point, so if I can get two really good dual-wield combos, he just melts, and I actually get that in this attempt. Like, in a second here, I'm going to get it to where I get another one of those for like 2,000 damage, and that's what closes out phase 2. So I really like the claws here, because the bleed is actually pretty strong. Like I said, that rolling attack with these has been doing it for me, but I really don't like this fight so far. I'm sure a lot of people who love challenges and stuff like that are going to stroke themselves in my tears talking about how much I don't like this, but there are a couple fundamental things I don't like, which really, it comes down to, like, I'm not good at the fight. I'm definitely not saying that I'm, you know, I'm not playing bad or something, but I'm having trouble with the same couple things, and one of them is just how much HP this fight has. Like, it is no joke how much life these three phases of this boss have. The first one isn't that much. It's like a good 4,000 or so. Maybe a little more. It's not that bad. And then in phase 1, she's not too difficult, but in phase 2, there's too much running around. There's too much AoE. And the big guy having a range attack and sprinting and all that, he's way bigger than Smo, which I think is a good comparison. It's that's kind of where the fundamental problems are. The reason ONS works, which I was talking about earlier in this video, and I thought about it more, it's because there are pillars in the room. You can kite and wedge them and, you know, do what you need to. I hate this attack. It's so scary. Because you want to run up on her because you think you can, and then she's always moving, and then you have to find her at the end. So it's not awful, but you really don't get a lot of time to hit her. That's the other thing. She has so much HP. Like, she just, this fight has everything. This fight has a ton of damage, a ton of life. The moveset's insane. Since she's got her scythe, all of her attacks are just her spinning. You know, like, it's really just you have to outrange her or roll through the last hit of a combo and then get a hit, and that's basically all you get, because she'll hyper armor and hit you through it, or she'll hyper armor and jump out. And then, like I said, she just does ridiculous damage. I can't get over it. Yeah, like, I don't have that much time, but the reason ONS works is because you have pillars to line of sight certain things, and Smo doesn't shoot. That's basically why that duo boss works. And you can do things like, you can pin Ornstein behind Smo, or like pin Ornstein behind a pillar and poke at Smo or something like that, and Ornstein will shoot lightning, and the lightning doesn't do a lot of damage, and it doesn't, I don't think it knocks down. That's the other thing. Everything in this fucking fight is a knockdown. Just a hard knockdown hit in most cases. And as you guys know from my Gundyr fight, knockdowns are the hardest to deal with in this game, and I don't know, I think you guys don't understand how hard they are when I talk about them. Because it just, you lose all advantage, all initiative, and it's just, if you ever played Street Fighter or something at a decent level, any fighting game, getting knocked down means you have to sit there and take whatever's coming. You know, and that's, you just get mixed up a lot, and so it's been tough. But like, when I had this attempt, I thought I could do this. It's just gonna take a ton of practice, and I honestly don't care enough. Kind of like, well, if you're making the videos and you're talking about it, why do you care? It's like, I don't want to prove myself in this game. You know, I'm not out for doing that. So, I don't know, I haven't decided what I'm going to do yet. I don't think I'm going to summon. I'm probably just going to be really stubborn. I'm eventually going to kill her. But I don't know when that is. I can't give you a timeline, because like I said, this has been so difficult. I just don't know what it's going to take besides a little bit of luck. Look how much damage this does. It's ridiculous. Anyway, that's where it is. When I finally kill her, I'll probably talk more about it, but yeah, thanks for watching. Next time, hopefully she dies. See you guys later.